It's a really interesting device in that you can't overload it unless you come to the end of the rope. So unless a knot hits the end of the rope here, you can't overload this device. What happens is the cam, once you reach about 6, maybe 7 kilonewtons if it's a old fuzzy rope, maybe 5.5 if it's a brand new shiny rope, it'll slip really predictably. So it'll just be that kind of extra, you know, and you could drop a load onto it. So I've got it clipped into me, right? And I've got 5 feet of slack. I fall off the beam, so I'm 5 feet below the beam now. And I put an immense amount of force on the device, the carabiner, my body, right? And if I hadn't, if I had just fallen on the rope tied to me, it would kill me. So that's how little this kind of static rope, if you fall 5 feet below it, you could kill yourself. There's that much pressure. This, that cam, will let another 2 or 3 feet of rope slide through, so you'll be 7 feet below, but you won't put any kind of pressure on yourself, the carabiner, or the device to hurt it or you. Does that make sense again? And it's all just because that cam will just slip a tiny little bit when it comes under really, really strong load.